Gaza, I would have been a bit skeptical about, you know. But I remember turning up, obviously with a suit, but with white tennis socks in my shoes. Right. And you don't really do that, do you? Well, we all need to belong to something. We all need some sort of a tribe to belong to. And I think that's scientifically proven. That's one of the ways to stay happy, to have life quality, is to sort of have your belong to a tribe. And for me, Tottenham is my tribe and it's my family, and it always will be. And it's also great because I've managed to convince my sons that Tottenham is the one and only club you should support. So and they're really diehard Tottenham supporters. And to have this together also within our own little family here is brilliant. And to follow the results, follow the club, the team, to travel over to watch, it's absolutely brilliant. And it also sort of brings us together here with this big Tottenham family. I think, I would say, Chris, do you remember Chris Armstrong?
Yeah, remember, yeah.
Yeah, he had only one, he couldn't use his left, he could only use his right, but he was really good with his right. Yeah. He had a really, really hard shot with his right. That's what I can remember. You know, I didn't play with Edman, you remember the Swede Edman?
Yeah.
Do you remember his shot from 45 meters
Anfield.
Out?
Yeah.
Oh, what an incredible shot that was.
Yeah.
I didn't play with him though, but it looked pretty hard to me. I would think that Mapsy, I thought might go for Gary Mabbott, might go for to be a manager. Colin Calderwood, definitely. Colin yeah. Calderwood, who's also he's been Chris Hughton's assistant coach a few mm-hmm. places. And Chris Hughton, of course, who was also there when I was there. I mean, he's a really, really sensible and intelligent guy. Now, I would say that the most natural, skillful player was Gaza. Gaza was just a massive natural talent. And the thing was, he loved to play football. I think that was his thing. And when he was on the pitch, he was free. And after maybe we stopped training after an hour and a half, he would go over and join the youth team and play another hour with them, but just because he loved to play football and because it was where he could sort of be at ease with himself. Because I'm standing behind the players and I just watch. What do goalkeepers do most of the time? Absolutely nothing. They just hang around and watch the others play. And Gaza, you know, when he got the ball, sometimes he could have been better off just knocking a quick pass straight away. But because he had this personal thing going on with the opposition, he just often waited for them. He just got the ball and he just waited two of the opposition would get close to him, and then he would just start to run with the ball. But then obviously he just often ended up with a good pass or a great shot anyway. So we wouldn't have won the FA Cup in 1991 without him, that's pretty sure. I mean, it's a team game, it's a team sport, but still he was incredible for that run. Well, the thing was, we used to room with the same people all the time. So I, you know, normally stayed with Gary Mabbott. So we shared rooms. Sometimes you got a favorite song and you can remember where you were the first time you heard that song. But I really like Don't Look Back in Anger by Oasis. And I remember I was sharing a room with Mapsy before a match, and he had brought a radio into the room, and that radio of his was playing that song the first time I heard it, and it will forever be stuck in my mind. And obviously, there's a few guys there. Gaza, I would have been a bit skeptical about, you know. Sedge as well, because there were so many pranks, you know, going on. I don't know, but I think it could have been me because I was a bit peculiar. Yeah, no, I had the sort of the my personal underwear that I used to use under the goalkeeping shirt, and I had bits and pieces here, and I always had some sort of a padding because I had bad knees and stuff like that. So they always had to look after me a bit special, and then I had they had to make sure that I had some extra contact lenses and stuff like that. So I'll put my name down for that one. The thing was, I found a small article. There's a survey in Europe about which European country had the worst dress sense, and it was very unanimous that it was England. And I showed this to some of my teammates, and they were like, yeah, it can't be, you know, because I mean, it changes from country to country. But I remember turning up, playing my first matches, obviously with a suit, which you had to have, but with white tennis socks in my shoes. Right. And you don't really do that, do you? So I quickly learned my lesson, don't do that. But apart from that, with the dress sense, I don't know. We foreigners used to get stick for that. Gudni Bergsson, Erik Thorstvedt, Naeem, you know, whatever. they told us off. I think Mitchell Thomas, he had the groove. I think I'm sort of way down the list. I think there's a song that Mick Jagger and David Bowie had to get together, Dancing in the Street.
That's it. Yeah.
And I remember some of the guys used to make fun of Mick Jagger's dancing in that video. And I always thought, well, I thought he was pretty good. If they're making jokes of that, I'm not going to dance in front of those guys. But I think Mitchell Thomas had it.